Hello everyone, welcome back to Spectrum Classes. In this video, we are going to discuss electrolytic conductance and many terminologies which are used for this electrolytic conductance. For example, electric conductivity, resistance, specific resistance or resistivity, and specific conductance, and many more terms, right? And how these terms are related to the cubic centimeters, right? So that we are also going to discuss in this video. This will help us to understand completely how electrochemistry works. And this electrochemistry topic is again very important from the exam point of view as well as from the research point of view. So if you are a researcher, then you can understand everywhere we are using electricity plus chemical reactions. So how these chemical reactions and this electricity is related to each other. For example, if we are measuring the conductivity, turbidity, pH meter, potential, corrosion, etc. Now, relation between electrical conductance and resistance. What is the relationship? So conductance or conductivity. In electrochemistry, instead of resistance, the term conductance, which is sometimes represented by C or sometimes represented by G, and in old books I have found this C and in the new books I have found this capital G, which means the ease with which the current flow through the conductor, that is called conductance, right? And you can understand this as by the formula G is equal to 1 upon R, where R is the resistance, G is the conductance, and it has unit inverse of this R. And as we know, R is in ohms, so what will be your G? G will be ohm inverse. And the SI unit, which is important, is Siemens, which is represented by this capital S, and this is named after famous electrical engineer Sir William Siemens. So the resistance of R of a conductor is directly proportional to the length L, and it is inversely proportional to the area of the cross section A. So here I am just writing these formulas, but in the next slide I will tell you the physical meaning of all these terminologies, right? R is proportional to L upon A as written over here, and if I remove this proportionality sign, then I need to incorporate one constant, which is known as proportionality constant, is represented by this RHO, rho, right? And here this is rho is equal to R into A upon L. So rho is the proportionality constant depending upon the nature of the material. This is important, and it is also called resistivity or specific resistance. So here if I am having a cube like this, which is having its side 1 centimeter, 1 centimeter, 1 centimeter, means this surface is having 1 centimeter square, and this surface is again having 1 centimeter square, and these two surfaces are kept at 1 centimeter distance. These are the electrode plates and these are kept at 1 centimeter apart. Then the resistance of this cube will be termed as specific resistance of this electrolytic solution. And now if I put in A is equal to 1 and L is equal to 1, A is area, area is 1 centimeter square, length is L, 1 centimeter. If I put all these values here in this equation, then I will get rho is equal to R. Means specific resistance of a conductor which is having area 1 centimeter square and length 1 centimeter, then the resistance of that particular conductor is termed as its specific resistance, and it is represented by this rho. Right, now coming to the units. So since rho is equal to R, R is in ohm, then ohm, and here from this, if you are just calculating the units from here, you will be wrong, right? So this will be ohm centimeter. Why this ohm centimeter? Because if you are putting all these values, units here, R is ohm, A is in centimeter square, and this is in centimeter, then you will get ohm centimeters, right? So this is how the unit of this rho is equal to ohm centimeters, right? So this is the unit of this rho. Now here I have written therefore the specific resistance of a conductor is the resistance in ohms which is offered by a cube, that is 1 cubic centimeters, to the passage of electricity. So this is the measure of that resistance, and this is termed as specific resistance or resistivity, right? Now we are just going to understand it in physical manner. Suppose this is a rectangle, though this is looks like a cube, and this has different dimensions, right? This is the height, length, and this is the width. And if we divide it into different cubes of 1 centimeter, suppose these are the cubes, in this many cubes it can be divided. Here you can understand, right? So here this can be divided. If dimensions of this cube are like this, then we can divide it in the cubes of dimension 1 centimeter into several cubes, which you can see. So 4 centimeter means 4 cubes, 1, 2, 3 and 4. Here 5 centimeter means 5 cubes, right? And here 3 centimeter means 3 cubes, 1, 1, 1, right? In this manner, this whole rectangle will be divided into different cubes. Now, if I remove one layer of this cube, here you can see one layer, this which is highlighted over here, if we separate out this layer from here to here, then what we will get? We will get this type of structure, right? So in this case we are having how many cubes? So 4 in this way manner and 5 in this manner according to its area, and each cube is having its resistance rho, suppose. So this is having its resistance rho because this is a cube of 1 centimeter dimension. Therefore, these all are having their resistance like this. Why I am elaborating all this? Because numericals have been asked on this concept. So these cubes are arranged in a parallel manner, right? So these are arranged in a parallel manner in this layer. And if these are arranged in a parallel manner in this layer, then the total resistance of this particular layer, if we designate it with small r, then we can calculate this small r. So if these are in parallel manner, then 1 upon r is equal to 1 upon rho and so on. So how many rows are there? So a times upon rho. A times, why I have written a times? Because 4 cubes this side, 5 cubes this side, total 20 cubes are there. So in this manner I will get total 20, which is the area of this layer, and the resistance of this particular layer is further connected with the second layer, this one, right? And these are connected in series, and the third one. So for the series we can calculate the formula like this. So here what you will see, 1 upon r is equal to a upon rho. If I write r is equal to rho upon a, right? So for this series we will calculate the total resistance for this cube. So total resistance for this cube will be equal to the resistance of this layer and the length of this cube. So because three layers, if this is the layer of 3 centimeters, then 3 cubes will be there. So length equal 3 layers will be there. So 3 times L times of R. And here you can just simply put R is equal to rho upon A from this equation, then you will get this. Right? So R is equal to rho L upon A. If I put this 1 upon r, if simply I write this 1 upon r is equal to 1 upon rho, and I will revert this a upon l, right? I hope you will understand this. So 1 upon r is called, this is called conductance. So this is the conductance, and what is this? Since rho is the specific resistance, then according to this we will get specific conductance. So here is the specific conductance. And what is called conductance? Conductance is A upon L times of specific conductance. So while we are measuring the conductance, this is the observed conductance, which is different if we are having this A upon L exactly at 1 centimeter and 1 centimeter, then the calculated specific conductance is exactly equal to the conductance, right? So here you just understand, if you are a researcher, then this point is very, very important for you, because on this we are going to measure the cell constant and conductivity of the solutions. This point I will elaborate further for the research students. If you are not a researcher, then you can skip this part easily. So here, if suppose we are applying if potential difference of 1 volts between these two plates. Here is the plate number 1, you can see, and this is the plate number 2, right? And these are kept at 1 centimeter apart, and these are, since this is height and this is width, so area of these layers will be 1 centimeter square. Here again 1 centimeter square, and these two plates are kept at 1 centimeter distance, and in this manner this will form a cube of a electrolytic solution. And if we apply 1 volts to this plates, then you can understand it, when a potential difference of 1 volt is applied to a centimeter cube of a conductor, the current in amperes flowing is equal to the magnitude of the specific conductance. And here, according to the Ohm's law, this I will solve it for you. According to the Ohm's law, here I is equal to V upon R, right? And this I, if we apply 1 volt potential, so I replace this volt, 1 volt, right? Then I is equal to 1 upon R, and in the previous slide we have written 1 upon R is equal to G. According to the previous slide, we are having this G is equal to K into A upon L, and this G is equal to what we can replace it. We can replace, if this A is 1 centimeter, L is 1 centimeter, then the G is equal to K, right? So if we kept our electrodes of 1 centimeter square at 1 centimeter distance, then the conductance of the solution is exactly equal to the specific conductance of the solution. And therefore, if I put all these values here, to understand this point that the current flowing through the conductor of 1 centimeter square and 1 centimeter apart is exactly equal to the specific conductance, right? So this is very important to understand, and in the next video I'm just going to tell you the relation between specific conductance, molar conductance and equivalent conductance, how they are related to each other and what is their physical meaning. I hope you find this video helpful. If you find this video helpful, please like, share and subscribe. Thank you all. Thanks for watching.